Hey everybody, I'm Adam.
I'm Kat.
I'm Nessa.
And Dustin.
And we are playing Tales of Eternia. We just spent some time getting new powers and getting the power of flight. So let's go scope out some of the places that we used to hang out in and really haven't visited in a while.
Let's go hassle the groundbound simpletons.
All right.
Silence, groundwalker.
First stop, Rasheen's village at nighttime. That's a lie. There's no nighttime. It's always daytime inside the village.
Yeah.
I don't know how they get to sleep.
They don't. Not
curtains,
since that day.
Yes. Yeah.
Oh, it's not voiced.
Unfortunately.
I'm disappointed. I was really looking forward to hearing him again.
What of it? There's no reason to worry. Like, no, I can't do it either.
Yeah.
That voice is impossible for any mortal to achieve.
I don't know. I don't know what I can do to fill the void left by that voice.
Listen to this guy. Bring me some medicine, and then we can talk, eh? Like, what?
It's a legendary medicine.
Yeah, of course it's a legend.
Yeah.
Get the greater cramel of medicine.
No other medicine will do.
You
must
get,
be the legendary medicine.
You can get my back medicine, you know, if you feel like it.
How does he even think it exists? It's just like, oh, my back's hurt.
It's okay. Helper bot is on the job.
I need some harpy blood.
Once again. All right, so.
Turns out the medicine's actually for the flu. Ah, jeez.
Banria.
Oh,
yeah.
That would bugs. Oh, I know where there's a fire in Gnostos Cave. I remember.
Is it the fire?
Yeah, that.
In Gnostos Cave?
Yeah. Who's that
right.
Dick?
What else do we need? Banria. One of them is goat horns. We got like a ton of those already.
Yeah.
Already done. If you're lucky, you're like tripping over them on your way up the mountain.
Yeah.
And you never sell them or do anything with them, right?
So, someone, why is everybody, like the first guy you talked to was all, oh, I only know one of the ingredients. But if all the knowledge is in Rasheen's, right? Then, like it's a small town.
Pool their knowledge.
Talk. Dried peels.
Sharing knowledge would limit their power.
Yeah.
It would make the knowledge Banria, diluted.
The Banria ingredient of power, wisdom, and courage.
For example,
separate.
We want to figure out what the Elder has to say, but he won't let us know until we get that medicine. Knowledge is power, man.
The only way to get an audience with the mayor.
Alright, so we're starting the Banria quest, and, you know, fart around while we're doing that.
We may as well fart around, really. What else are we gonna do? Save the world?
Nah.
Yeah, the end of the world can wait.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's so many Suum away.
Yeah.
Right. So, with flight, you know, just, you can sort of go around the Inferia loop, visit any place that you are curious about. You know, there are a lot of extra scenes in areas that you visited, even if you don't necessarily get anything out of them.
There's disc 3.
Yeah, there's one such scene in Moral. Oh, you have no idea, Mazette. You have no idea. Yeah, we went that way.
Yeah, no biggie.
Yeah, we just came here in our airplanes and decided to drop by.
Yeah. Once we finished raiding the evil House of Horrors tomb of a long dead pirate, we got the power of flight. Figured we'd swing on past.
Yeah, pay a visit. Do you want to go for a ride?
Yeah.
You can ride with Keel. Meredith is full. She's got to deal with Quickie.
Yeah.
And honestly, I'm surprised she keeps it in the air.
Yeah, and Reed hasn't bathed in a while, so you can't go with him.
Yeah.
Weird lectures indeed.
Plus he's kind of a dick, right? kind of a dick.
All right. Barol time. Now, again, a lot of these side quests don't really give you anything out of it. Most of it's just to complete your collector's book. I know we're not going to get 100% in the collector's book, but, you know, we're still, you know, content, right? It's that thief kid again.
Beat him up.
He's going straight.
No.
Then he can rob from people legally.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like that guy behind the counter. Double pricing. There are no defenses for such crimes. All right. Potpourri. Doesn't do anything.
It's not a fertilizer. This might be a reference to Tales of Destiny, where there's a really long plants fertilizer item getting side quest.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. I never did it, but there. I couldn't be bothered. Sorry, internet.
All right, you can go to any room you want in the hotel now.
Can we get the one with that really affectionate maid again?
No. Well, probably, but I don't think she works here anymore.
Oh, yeah.
You know, drama.
Yeah.
Hey, story time with Farrah!
Ooh.
What?
A leg stealing ghost?
I don't know which hotel. Good night!
You know what?
I just decided to wake up to tell this horrifying story.
Yeah.
At this point, I'd like to mention that Farrah and Reed and Keel have known each other all their lives, so there's no way Farrah doesn't know Reed is terrified of ghosts.
Yeah, we've seen it multiple times in this Let's Play alone, so...
Right. So she's pretty deliberately telling a story about ghosts being in the place where they are right now to Reed before he goes to bed.
Wouldn't I don't you? Know which hotel.
I mean, yeah, I totally would too, but I'm kind of a dick.
Yeah.
And like Nessa said, she just ruined every hotel forever for Reed.
Well, no,
for
now
some
he
reason,
knows...
is keeping his legs uncovered as
now
opposed to under the sheet.
Now he knows which hotel it is.
Wake up, Merity. Wake up, Keel.
Yeah, Keel will protect you. Yeah. Get big, strong Keel to save you from the ghost, Reed. That's a great idea.
Oh, and Farrah's just going to punch the ghost?
Well, yeah, she'll punch anything.
She'll try to punch
the
ghost.
We got through the Forest of Temptation. She punched a lot of ghosts.
Oh, yeah.
Don't take my legs.
We also got through Aifread's tomb.
This place is full of ghosts.
Yeah, tons of ghosts. So yeah, punching ghosts, not new. He hasn't slept at all.
Are you on drugs, Reed? Is that what this is?
Oh, awesome. They have one room left.
Oh.
Hooray!
Yay! We still get to sleep at the hotel.
I think if you say no, the side quest should go on anyway, but unfortunately it doesn't.
Thanks, maid.
Now make me a soft cake. The ghost is here.
It's a ghost.
A ghost.
Quick, everyone, uncover your legs.
Yeah.
I don't want to be the only target.
Oh, this is a cat. It's like a Miacus, but Inferian, and it shouts, "Give me your legs." This raises further questions.
Yeah. I don't...
Oh, brother.
Oh, ghost cat. Oh, it was old man the maid the whole time. Trying to keep everybody away from the hotel room so she could pillage all the Spanish doubloons from under the covers. brilliant. She would have gotten away with it too if it weren't for what? So the cat just says, give me your legs.
Yes.
Instead of meowing, it says, give me your legs.
I would have gone with, I want your soul.
It's a weird trick to teach a cat.
It's a weird trick to keep. Like, what words does your cat know?
Maybe it's just a meow. Ghost. I've
My
heard
cat
say...
hangs out in the bathroom and says, you know, tell me you love me. Like
I've heard
Alone
her meow
too.
In a way that sounds like hello once. Cats can make some pretty weird sounds if they want to.
Hmm.
All right.
Let's get the hell away from here.
Yeah. From the creepy cat ghost.
Yeah.
All right. What else is there?
We can go to Nacho Cave and get some nachos.
Nacho Cave?
Nachos.
You know what? We got some stuff we gotta wrap up over here.
Are we finally gonna do the criminal personality quiz?
No.
Damn it.
We're gonna do that lens you keep bugging me about.
That was the gag. That was the...
Yeah.
Guess.
Yeah. Power of light. This
what could it be?
I think we're a couple episodes too late for that joke, Dustin.
Yeah. Alright, 49.
Oh, hey, 49.
Moving on.
Out of 50, right?
Nope.
What?
Nope.
How many are there?
60.
That's a stupid number. That's a stupid number.
Oh. You're a stupid number. Alright, so make our way over to... Where are you? Around here somewhere. Somewhere nearby the... Actually, we'll go get this one first, and then we'll make our way to the secret area near Aifread's cave.
Okay.
Aifread's Inferno Cavern. This secluded little field over here has got a lens. That makes 50.
I love how every game with some sort of airship always has hidden areas surrounded by mountains.
Of course they do.
Well,
you get like crappy materia and stuff.
It's true.
Like, why do I need this?
The good materia you can't take the airship to.
Man.
All
right. So you got this tiny little forest here.
A chocobo forest.
Pretty conspicuous. Now it's
if
time
I don't
for
see chocobos.
The Hot Springs episode!
Yay!
Every Tales game has to have a Hot Springs episode.
This is actually probably the less obnoxious one.
Yeah, this is the least creepy one out of the lot.
It's true. They make up for it in the anime, if you were watching the anime stream with us.
Sup, chat? What kind of pirate doesn't like the water? Oh, I see.
Let's just mind our own business.
They're doing that joke. Alright, moving on.
Yeah.
Moving on.
Pharaoh will fight you.
No but. Move on.
Come on, move on.
Don't.
Moving on.
Drop the joke.
Okay.
All right, we're in.
Whoa! What the hell?
These little statues are how Chat learns her abilities.
Why did Aifread leave one of those in the men's changing room at the hot springs?
Probably fell out while it was changing.
I guess that makes sense.
Yeah, he dropped it.
Yeah, because... We already know that Aifread kind of has this nudity puzzle theme going on. Yeah.
The real question is, why didn't Aifread drop it in the women's changing room? That would be even weirder. What was he even doing there?
Aifread's not allowed in the women's change room.
He's not allowed in space, but he found a way.
He's a pirate.
He's not allowed in space.
Breaking rules is what pirates do best, as long as they don't use underhanded tactics or violence or cannons. I like to think that his entire piracy career is just like mild civil disobedience, like crossing against the walk sign and Double parking.
He was right there with Gandhi.
He was a true hero.
Yeah. But yeah, there's one of these in one of the underground caves in Inferia as well. Didn't manage to record that one, but they're all over the place. There's some random ones in Celestia somewhere. Just little statues that give chat skills. They're all garbage.
Yeah, this one is Paraball.
What?
He looks like a ghoul.
He looks really like does.
Gumby. Yeah.
That's why Kiel wears robes.
He gets a pretty dashing figure. Gotta say.
Oh.
Yeah, that was refreshing, all right, Farrah.
Reads Gumby's horse.
Gumby's horse's name is Pokey, you uncultured lout.
All right.
Gumby's culture now?
Yeah.
Absolutely. Anyway.
Everything's culture.
Check around. It's new Where school. Is it?
Oh,
no. I know there's a lens in that room.
So he left?
Well, somewhere around here. Can't go in there.
Unless you're Farrah.
What if we have Farrah? Nope. Farrah can't do it either.
Not even women are allowed in the women's changing room. That's yep, how tight security is. Yep, women are allowed
in the men's one.
Whatever. We gotta stay a second time anyway.
This time let's not be weirdos?
Nope. This time we're just gonna spend some time in the ladies' hot spring. Peeling those karimas.
Look how gentlemanly quick he is. He's not even looking.
If I were quickie, I would be going after those karimas.
Yeah, fruit.
Maybe but he hates getting wet.
Maybe he's carnivorous. Like, what does quickie eat? Thread, tell me what quickie eats. Thread.
Cramels.
I asked Cramels from thread, around the world. Not, I didn't ask you.
To complete the blue fibril.
To be fair, everything's made of cramels.
I like to think he survives on Merity's tears.
He'd be way fatter in that case.
There we are.
He eats people. He's just stalking the party right now. Just waiting.
Yeah, that's why they had to send him in a spaceship off to Inferia. That was the real reason. Alright. So... up just a bit south of Barol, you want to go under the water. Specifically, there's a cavern down here. Hideout number 3.
Ooh.
I mean, there are, I think, 4 or 5 hideouts down here. They've all got treasure in them.
Yeah, we had to visit them when we were getting the,
No, that was Celestia.
Oh.
The inferior ones are totally optional. They just have treasure. This one's got a lens. So, we're going to go ahead and get that. Ninja sword. Honestly, the ninja sword is really good, actually. It's pretty potent against Rem, so if you come out to Hideout 3, the ninja sword is a good substitute for any darkness weapon you might be carrying. Because, you know, while it's not shadow elemental, it makes up for it in sheer power.
Hmm.
Yeah. We didn't, so I used the dark thing.
Rem was a good fight.
Yeah, Rem was hard.
Okay.
Alright. On the ship. Where are we going? There's a lens over in this room.
We already got this one, actually. Out of the barrel.
Oh, yeah.
We made jokes about needing drinks.
Right. Yes.
Yeah.
I forgot that joke.
It's a good joke.
An engine piece sort of thing has a lens on it.
There's engine pieces all over the vent.
Yeah, I know.
There it is.
54. So we're almost there.
Well, we're working on it.
Hey, Merity. Quickie's ready to go. I thought there was a thing over here too, but eh, whatever. I'm not looking to jump out. Just thing opens, Merity pushes him into the ocean.
No problem.
That's Farrah's catchphrase.
Yeah, and she learned it from Farrah.
No, probably. Right,
pushing him out.
That makes sense.
Alright, so
that's how this works, right, Farrah?
On the ship out of the way.
Now we're in Celestia.
Oh, yeah. I'm not doing these in any particular order.
Yeah, we're just kind of dicking around. We just bought Nostos Cave. The closest of the three things to Rasheen's was the last one we...
Last one we get.
Last one we get, because we already had the Falcia Horns.
Well, you know, we gotta hit them all eventually. Alright, Iman. I remember there's one in the weapon shop.
Oh, Iman. Gone are your deedles and your doodles.
Yeah.
Only misery right remains here.
We hardly knew ye.
Oh, shit. I already got this one. All right. Moving on. There are several more on Celestia. This was not a waste.
I'm in the downer.
Yeah.
I'm totally down now.
We should start just, like, picking stuff up.
I've been downed.
Just, like, start rebuilding it.
You know, we should.
Tales of Symphonia has a town like that, actually, where it gets destroyed by something.
So does my favorite good example game. Yeah, I remember that. Xenoblade Chronicles!
Yeah, and you can rebuild... Well, Symphonia is destroyed, and you can rebuild it. Whereas Xenoblade Chronicles, they're like, it's like a new location. Whereas Symphonia, they're rebuilding the old town.
No, you're rebuilding the old town in Xenoblade Chronicles. Colony 6?
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I thought they moved.
No, they were refugeeing in another place for a while.
Oh, okay. Fair enough. Right between these two mountains. There we go. Now this one's obscure as heck. 55.
I'm still kind of down from Iman, and the Celestia music isn't helping.
Yeah,
Celestia's depressing and sucky.
They don't get enough sunlight there.
Yeah, I know.
I like Celestia.
Well, it's...
I think the slate blues are really nice.
It's depressing, and there is nothing cheerful or enjoyable about Celestia at all, even despite all the dancing they do in Perudi. Like, forget it. Worthless.
What's this, the Cold Springs?
Mia, kiss to our hearts.
Indeed.
Yeah. We're coming for you.
Why is everyone in this town wearing kitty pajamas?
Max would love this town.
Oh my god.
Oh god.
Yeah, Meredy, who are these people?
Probably...
Keel's at least polite enough to recognize them as people.
The cats.
Oh.
So cats are a weird thing. I believe Tales of Destiny had a cats.
Oh, the sign just says welcome. Why'd that take me so long to be able to read?
Nice. I think Tales of Destiny had a cats. Yeah. Singular.
There's just this kid wearing kitty pajamas.
I guess they thought that joke was so funny that they just run with it. And so this one has a full cats village. And I think every single Tales game has a cats village. Or at least a trial.
It's been a staple of the Tales series.
Yeah.
I remember that scene, Farrah. Then what happened? Yeah, I hate Reed. Oh, she's so cool.
My hero. Huh. See, you're not just a mean boss. They're just bugging him.
They just...
Good God.
Oh, goodness.
Oh, God. Look at that. Look at that text box.
He's gonna fill all of it.
Ah.
He keeps doing it.
Keel's loving every moment of this.
People who will listen to me?
Oh, Farrah has a bigger audience.
Oh, yeah.
I remember when that happened! He is a dick! Then what did you do?
Another surprise.
The same guy who had you executed?
Jeez.
I hate that guy!
I hate everybody now. They're all so happy.
Everyone's entranced by Farrah.
Right. Oh, goodness.
Oh. Whoa!
I'm gonna call you Bee Lady.
I'm gonna call you Dead Meat.
Oh, Christ.
He's still doing it! Are they actually comprehending him? Like,
I know. Yeah, I think they're just being polite.
Is he talking about?
To Keel's be fair, audience he probably, is not grown.
He probably started at the beginning and explained all of reality to them.
When he's talking about the secondary Doctark effect brought on by observing a Kramel's motion, isn't he just talking about basic quantum physics, except putting Kramel in it?
I think so, yeah.
Pretty much.
I hate you, Kiel. I hate you so much.
Well, quantum Kramel physics is a thing. It's a very advanced field of Kramelology.
I'm sure that people in kitty pajamas are delighted to hear about this.
Quantum Kramelology has a liberal bias.
That booth up behind Farah has cat toys. And they're just wobbling.
Yes, they are. If you want 100% this game, you definitely have to come to Cat's Village.
Can't this is magical.
Alright.
Guess it's time to go. Thanks, Cat's Village. They picked my spirits back up, those adorable little kitty pajama people.
Thanks, cats. Fats.
They like the stories. Even Kiel's, apparently.
Alright, but yeah, go back into Cat's Village. We have changed the place. Okay, there's nothing here. So happy to say that. Do you want to play?
He's just play with the cat toys. Yay!
This is one of the two places in the game that you can buy purple satay. You can only buy them one at a time here, but you can buy them en masse in Gnome Village. Oh, have a mushroom. Oh god!
What?
He just shaved that living mushroom.
What?
Hey guys.
I think...
Don't be with Kiel. I love it.
they're playing the story Reed told them. Cat's children are adorable. Like those little cats and they're so impressionable.
They're all insane, footy pajama-wearing crazy peoples.
There's another lens.
Like the children are playing games based on the stories they've been... All of them do that, don't they?
Yeah.
Cats never grow up, do they?
Nope.
No.
Now they're even writing fan fiction about Max and Isla.
I want to be a cats now. Yeah, it seems so much easier.
Like, what kind of jobs do cats have? Guy who sits at a booth and plays with toys?
Somebody had to
make
that
booth.
Oh my god!
Oh goodness!
They actually were listening to Kiel's story. That's way more than we did.
They're saying things from it.
It's theoretically unfeasible.
Alright.
They're just playing scientist.
Those two lens are what we came here for.
What has Kiel created?
I like to think he did the voice. What?
Oh, look. An elder cats.
They've got the whole...
Oh, my goodness.
It's Princess Kitty Arende.
Yeah, to my knowledge, every Tales game has cats, and it's usually pretty funny.
Fantasia?
No. Since Destiny. Destiny has one, this game has a bunch from there. Fantasia doesn't have any.
Yeah?
Yeah, so not quite a staple.
Not quite, but almost.
Has since become a staple.
It's true.
Yeah.
We've said staple about things that are less common than the cats.
Maxwell.
It's true. And the cats are pretty adorable.
Yeah.
Oh, hey, it's our boat. Oh, this happens, by the way. You can summon the Van Eltia if you're over water or the Eyebird.
Anytime. Or if you're walking around by a shore at any time.
Yeah. So now where are we headed?
All right. So... Where to next? I believe we have an errand in Nacho Cave.
Alright. Man, I want nachos.
That sounds about... Yeah. Alright, so it was the fire in Nosso's Cave for the final ingredient of Banrea. That's not the one.
No, that's where the horrible slaughter of the Eggbear family happened.
Yeah.
This is where the horrible slaughter of the rest of the Egg Bear family happened.
Oh, yeah. But then we turned into jerky.
Twice. Beauty.
All right. So all right. I bet we get something really exciting.
You can actually use the firewood bug and the peels and the horn. I don't know what they do. I don't want to use it because then we won't have them anymore.
Do these cutscenes only happen once?
No. I think you can do them again, but...
Why?
Why? Exactly. And with that, we can return the Banraya and finally get a reward from the Elder. Man, I really should have sped these up.
Yeah.
I did it for the sailing parts. Figured the flying was fast enough. Not the case.
You know, it always seems really fast when you first get an air transportation thing in an RPG, but all of a sudden you're just like, fly faster.
Yeah.
Because you know how fast you move in any RPG? It's not fast as fast enough. As you want.
What's worse, though, is when you go back and you're used to the fastest mode of transportation and you're stuck walking.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's like, I recently started New Game Plus of Xenoblade Chronicles, and I've got so many quick step gems equipped, but it still feels slow because I've been moving at that speed all game, but it's still way faster than I was walking on my first playthrough. You don't even care.
Yeah.
Final Fantasy XII International Zodiac Job System apparently has a fast forward button for gameplay.
Oh, jeez. That's kind of awesome.
Yeah, it is.
Alright, now what do you got for us, Elder Dude?
Something cool, right? Good. Something we can go tell the cats about?
Drum roll, please.
We are even now. Be on your way.
So did you just, like, put the bugs and the peels and the horns and a mortar and pestle?
I think so.
A wind bell.
Ooh!
We got the wind bell. The wind bell does nothing.
Well, way to go.
Ooh.
Worth as much as a legendary medicine is?
Yeah. It's a legendary bell that does nothing. Alright. Oh, I'm glad we finally got all that out of the way. Next time, we'll move on to something more meaningful. So,
see you then.
Bye.